Hi, we are FoJo. Percussion duet began from University of Kansas about a year ago.
And tonight we're going to be performing for you a piece of percussion theater music. It is called Gone Dog Gone, and it was composed in 2012 by American composer Mark Applebaum.
I first became interested in this piece after suffering from tendonitis. For a percussionist, it can be devastating, and I wasn't able to play for an entire year. Instead of giving up, I decided to find a piece that will have a less impact on my body. So I asked my good and sexy friend, Johnathon, whether he would like to perform this piece with me.
Obviously, I said yes. So here's Gone Dog Gone. It has 8 movements. It sounds like this. Thank you. Into this piece a little bit deeper. Obviously, this is not something that Bach, Mozart, or Beethoven would have written. It uses some different instruments. We have two toms, a Tai-Jung, a cowbell that is stuffed with foam, a plastic container, a wood slat that doesn't like to stand upright, a glass milk jar, and a thick cymbal. It's called a zil belt, and we've taped it to the bottom of a saucepan. So in percussion nomenclature, we refer to these as found objects.
My favorite of these objects is saucepan, which is underneath a thick cymbal. We experimented with 20 different pans as we were seeking the right one. Those handles were sold off at the hardware store that just to make us easier to play. The other one is the plastic container. It's pretty special. It came from Taiwan, and I don't remember this, but apparently I was adamant when we first began rehearsing that Johnathon not break it. It's still making him really nervous.
So the rhythms we just played actually come from popular music. For instance, in the beginning, I was playing the Beatles' Day Tripper, AC/DC's Back in Black, and Wild Cherries Play That Funky Music. This is sort of how it goes. Here it is again. So when Popo and I put together, we're actually playing two different songs at the same time, and we move through them about every 1 to 4 measures. So when she starts the piece, she's actually playing The Kinks' All Day and Night, Led Zeppelin's The Ocean, and Aerosmith's Walk This Way. I'll demonstrate this real quick. And going along with these rhythms, we have 83 nonsense hand gestures, and they were actually written out by the composer. So to start off, we have Superman, Smear Blackout, Statue of Liberty, Eye Poke, Tea Party, Cup Water, and Bucket Lift. So let's put all of these three elements together real quick.
Gone Doggone is a piece that pushes the boundary of what music is by incorporating theater and popular culture.
It shows that music is just as diverse as the people who make it and those who sit in the audience.
Thank you for allowing us to share the music we are passionate about with you. Thank you.